written by the famous writer Rabindranath Tagore. Have you heard about Rabindranath Tagore? Yes, sure. Yes. He has written our Janagana Mana, isn't it? Then Rabindranath Tagore, he was a Bengali poet, musician, painter, and song composer. He was born on 7th May 1861 at Kolkata and died on 7th August 1941. He was the first non-European to win Nobel Prize in Literature. He was referred to as the Bard of Bengal, and one of his favorite books, all of you may know, Geetanjali. Okay, this I hope all of you have got a small idea about the poet Rabindranath Tagore. And let's start our today's class. All of you open your textbook page number 48. The banyan tree. Oh, you shaggy headed banyan tree, standing on the bank of the pond. Have you forgotten the little child? Like the birds that have nested in your branches and left you. Do you not remember how he sat at the window and wondered at the tangle of your roots that plant underground? The women would come to fill their jars in the pot, and your huge black shadow would trickle on the water like slaves struggling to wake up. Sunlight danced on the ripples like restless tiny shutters, waving golden tapestry. Two ducks saw by the weedy margin above their shadows, and the giant would still on them. He longed to be the wind and blow through your rustling branches, to be your shadow and lengthen with the day on the water, to be a bird and perch on your topmost tree and flaunt like those ducks among the weeds and shadows. Have you got any idea, children? Yes, just come back to this poem. Listen, in this poem, the poet Rabindranath Tagore, he recollects some memories from his childhood. Okay, banyan tree, all of you are familiar with the banyan tree. Our national tree is the banyan tree. Okay, and now our poet Rabindranath Tagore, he is memorizing some of his childhood experiences. Then just listen. Oh, you shaggy headed banyan tree. Do you know the word meaning shaggy? Okay, shaggy means long and untidy. All of you open your notebook, then write this heading section 3, the banyan tree, and list out the new words. Okay, and also, while I am saying the meaning, write down the meaning also in your notebook. Okay. Our poet Rabindranath Tagore is calling the banyan tree. Oh, you shaggy headed banyan tree. You know, the banyan tree, all of you know the structure of the banyan tree. It will have its branches and its leaf, its roots, everything all of you know. Oh, you shaggy headed banyan tree means, is its branches and its roots are very neat? No, not at all, all of you know. Shaggy means long and untidy. The banyan tree's roots and its branches, you know, it is long and also it is not at all neat, and no order, also everything is in disorder. For you shaggy and your banyan tree, shaggy means long and untidy. And you must standing on the bank of the pond. Banyan tree is standing on the bank of the pond. It is nearby the pond. Okay. Then the poet is asking to the banyan tree, have you forgotten the little child? Oh, my dear banyan tree, have you forgotten the little child? Or have you remembered the little child? Like the birds that have nested in your branches and left you. All of us know, the birds will make nest on the trees, isn't it? Will they stay every year or every time or forever on the trees? No. After a duration, for some time only the birds will stay there on the trees. After that, they will find out another trees, isn't it? Like that, the boy also loved the banyan tray that the poet is asking. Oh, my dear shaggy-headed banyan tree. The poet is describing the banyan tree, how it's looking. The banyan tree is long and untidy and it is standing near by a pot. Okay, and the poet is asking to the banyan tree, have you forgotten the little child? Have you forgotten the little child who was standing near by you? Oh, forgotten the little child also, like the birds that have nested in your branches and left you. Okay, Apollo, we have understood these stanzas?
Yes.
Do you not remember how he sat at the window and wondered at the tangle of your rose that clung on the ground? Again, our poet is asking, do you not remember how he sat? Have you remember how the boy was sat? Okay, have you remember or do you not remember how he sat? When he was a child, do you remember how he sat? And at the window, he sat at the window and wondered at the tangle of your roots. Tangle of your roots, you know, something twisted together. That all of you know, the roots of the banyan tree, it will be in a twisted way that you could see now. Which word you got next word, write it in your notebook, tangle. Do you not remember how he sat at the window and wondered at the tangle of your roots? And the boy was wondering about the roots of the banyan tree that was twisted. Tangle means something twisted together. Okay, the boy was wondering about the structure of the roots of the banyan tree. That means the banyan tree's roots were twisted together. Okay, and that plunged underground. Plunged means moved to a particular direction. This banyan tree's roots were moved to the underground, isn't it? Then the next line. The women would come to fill the jars in the pond. Through this line also we will understand the banyan tree is standing near by a pond. Okay. The banyan tree. The women would come to fill the jars in the pond. Sometimes the women will come near by the pond. Do you know for which purpose they are simply coming? No, no. They have to fill their pots. They have to fill their jars. The women would come to fill their jars in the pot, and your huge black shadow would dribble on the water like slaves struggling to wake up. Just imagine in your mind, if you are going with a jar nearby a pot, okay, then you know the water surface will be in a resting way. Whenever you are dipping your jar or your pot, you know, there will be ripples will be there. Ripples mean all of you know that water will move and like a small wave will be there. Okay, that is ripples. Okay. And your huge black shadow would ripple. At that time, you know, the banyan tree is near by the pond. At that time, you know, we could see the shadow of the banyan tree very clearly in the pond. But what will happen, you know, when the women come to take water from the pond, it's the banyan tree's shadow also will move, isn't it? Huge black shadow will wriggle. Wriggle meaning, you know, twist and turn quickly. Next word, wriggle. Okay, wriggle means twist and turn quickly. When the women dip their pots, at that time the shadow of the banyan tree will wriggle. Wriggle means quickly. Okay, all the water like sleeps struggling to wake up. Just imagine the banyan tree, sometimes he may be sleeping. Okay, its shadow may be sleeping. When the women come to take water from their pot, at that time, you know, the poet is imagining that just like someone is calling someone from the sleep. That much beautiful imagery the poet Vivekananda Tagore has used in this poem. The shadow would trickle on the water like slaves struggling to wake up. Whenever if anyone is calling you from your sleep, what do you feel on the spot? Do you get up from the bed? No. The shadow will wriggle on the water. The body is comparing the black shadow will wriggle, that he is comparing to the asleep, struggling to wake up. Okay, that means because of the presence of this woman, that shadow of the banyan tree also moving. Okay, you understand, children? Yes. Okay. Sunlight danced on the ripples like restless tiny shuttles waving gold in tapestry. One vigorous beat is used here. Which one? Yes, in this line, the vigorous beat it is used is simile. Okay, simile, what's simile? You know, the direct comparison between two things by using the words. Yes, like for us. Okay. Sunlight danced on the ripples like at that time, you know, that reflection of the sunlight may be in the spot, okay, in the water. At that time, the poet is saying that the sunlight danced on the ripples. Ripples, how you got the idea? And the sunlight is reflecting on the ripples, and the sunlight danced on the ripples like restless tiny shackles. Shackles, the meaning is given here. A pointed tool used in making clocks. Okay, shackle. Sunlight danced from the ripples like restless tiny shackles. At that time, you know, the sunlight is dancing with the ripples without any rust. Restless means without taking any rest, and waving golden tapestry. Tapestry means a large piece of cloth. Okay, in that cloth we will create some beautiful pictures also. You have you seen the process of waving? That will somewhat like this will be, isn't it? If you are seeing, means like that their hands will move in this way. Actually, the ripples also are moving in this way. Then the poet is comparing the movement of the ripples to the part, you know. Someone is waving the ball and tapestry. The poet is comparing the ripples with the somebody is waving the ball and tapestry. Okay. Then the next line. Can you follow me? Yes. Okay. Two depths saw by the reedy margin above their shadows. In this picture, you could see the two depths they are swimming. Okay. That. Two depths formed by the weedy margin above their shadows, above this tree's shadow, that is in this picture, the two depths are swimming. Okay, two depths formed by the weedy margin above their shadows. Weedy, you know the meaning. Weedy means unwanted plants. Okay, above their shadows, and the child would sit, and the child would sit still and think. At that time also, the boy is memorizing that when the ducks also were singing, at that time also the boy was sitting near the bank of the pond and he was thinking something. That means he may be the boy, maybe not, maybe the boy surely enjoying the beauty of the nature. Actually, really, this poem is related to that nature. The poet is describing the beauty of the nature. Okay, in the last lines, he longed to be the wind. Our poet wished, long means wished. Devindranath Tagore, our poet, longed to be the wind. He wished to be, if he could become the wind. Okay, what will happen, you know, and to blow through the rustling branches. The poet is wishing that, the poet has a wish that if he is a wind, okay, then he could blow through your rustling branches. The poet could blow through his rustling branches, means the trees branches will move with the wind, isn't it? If I am a wind, I could blow through your rustling branches to be your shadow and lengthen with the day on the water. I could be your shadow, to be your shadow, and lengthen with the day on the water, to be a bird, or if I am a bird, and perch on your topmost beak, sorry, topmost tree. If I am a wind, I could blow through your rustling branches. So, if I am a bird, what will happen? You know, what I will do, you know? I will sit on your cheek, I will sit on your branch and I will take rest from you. And float like a dawn sticks among the winds and shadow. If I am the Texina, I will sing, I will float like those dexes. If I am the dex, I will sing and throw the weeds and shadow. That means the poet is describing the beauty of the banyan tree and its surroundings. Have you understood, children? Who is our poet? Yes, the famous poet Rabindranath Tagore has written this poem. He is describing the beauty of the banyan tree. This poem is related to nature, and the poet is describing the banyan tree, how it is looking. Now, the poet in this poem, the poet is recollecting his childhood memories. Okay. Now he is a grown-up person. Whatever he is memorizing his childhood experiences, when he was a child, he sat nearby the banyan tree, and the banyan tree, it was nearby a pond, and whatever things are happening nearby the banyan tree, our poet is describing with the beautiful imagery, and also he is using this simile also. Okay, then the poet is using the word shaggy. Shaggy means long and untidy. Okay. Shaggy means long and untidy. Okay. The poet is describing the branches of the branches or the roots of the banyan tree. It is shaggy. It is long and it is disorder. Okay. It's not at all neat. And he is asking to the banyan tree, have you forgotten the little child who sat near by you? Or have you forgotten the little child also, like the birds that have left you? Okay, the birds are leaving the banyan tree, isn't it? The not of the banyan tree, the birds will search for one another tree. And like that, have you forgotten the little child also? Because you know, he also loved the banyan tree. The poet is asking his love to the banyan tree. Have you forgotten me? Then you know, the poet is describing that the poet was sitting nearby the banyan tree. He was wondering about the twisted roots of the banyan tree that is planted underground. And he is describing that the women are coming to take water from the pond. At that time, when they are dipping the ponds in the water, that time there will be ripples, isn't it? Then it is somewhat like someone is calling the banyan tree from his sleeping, because the shadow of the banyan tree also in the water. And the next one is, and also when the women are dipping their pond, at that time the sunlight, the poet is feeling the sunlight is dancing with the ripples. Okay, because the reflection of the sunlight and the water at that time, the sunlight also dancing. It is somewhat like someone is waving the golden tapestry. And again, some visitors are going to the pond, you know, the ducks. The ducks are swimming in the water. Okay. And the poet is remembering he was sitting nearby the banyan tree. At last, the poet is describing his wish. The poet has the wish that if he could become the wing, he could blow through the banyan tree, or if he could become a bird, he could sit on the twig of the banyan tree, or take rest from the banyan tree. And if he is the dex, he could swim through the ponds. Okay, anyway, the poet is using beautiful imagery and also similes to describe the beautiful poem, the banyan tree. Do you like the poem, children? Yes, while I am reading this poem, you have to pictureize this in your mind, then that will be very beautiful. You must read this poem at least 3 times now itself and just copy the meanings into your notebook. value means something disturbed. Something disturbed. Trigger, trigger. Trigger means stir. Could be a chapter in a meaning.
Hope you have understood this form.